This week, I'm joined by three regulars. We have Tom Garrity from Garrity Group Public Relations. Julianne Grimm is also with us today. She's editor and publisher at the Santa Fe Reporter. And hello to Rebecca Latham, CEO at Girl Scouts of New Mexico. Thank you all for being here. Now, President Joe Biden met with the governor, legislators, and emergency operations workers on Saturday. He says the federal government would assume the full cost of the 320,000-acre Hermit's Peak Calf Canyon fire, started by prescribed burns, as you know. It's devastated a 500-square-mile chunk of northern New Mexico. And the president's pledge was the bare minimum in the eyes of the governor and a lot of New Mexicans. And Tom, let me start with you. How did you see this visit? And specifically, did the president set the right tone here with his visit?
Oh, I think he set the tone that was needed.
Okay.
Most definitely. You know, there was the promise of reimbursement to the state of New Mexico. There was possible resolution for landowners who are kind of, you know, caught in that limbo of only having 75% of their losses reimbursed. But more importantly, I think what this did was is it helped to close a narrative that we really needed to move on from this active fire season. Even though it's still very active, these two fires started by a prescribed burn and a pile burn ended up, really capturing the attention and defining in some respects, the state of New Mexico for a time. A lot of people, are wondering, you know, about travel, things of that nature, when in actuality, it's just a very remote area and a lot of, great small towns that were impacted. But I think it was the needed tone that the president set, to help kind of close this narrative that of responsibility that the federal government is going to take.
Mm-hmm. You know, Julianne, the president said he saw the devastation from the air on the way in. Adding that wildfires have damaged an astounding amount of land, saying, we saw the quote, it looked like a moonscape. There's been some criticism that they would like to have seen the president on the ground actually taking a look. Does that make a difference to you or to folks you might have been talking to about this?
Yes, I think that, you know, despite the tone or the optics of this visit, this visit wasn't really for the people of New Mexico. Start off with the fact that the only media who were allowed in the room was the Albuquerque Journal. Mm-hmm. They were assigned to be the pool, and while they are cooperative and provide pool information, you know, organizations like the paper in Las Vegas, closest to the fire, the Santa Fe Reporter, the Rio Grande Sun, we weren't invited. We asked, we begged, we got mad, didn't do any good. I finally got an email from the White House this morning that said the reason for that was, COVID, which I think is disingenuous considering that the president met with 60 people in a room in Santa Fe. And I do think that the people who were affected by this fire would have much more appreciated seeing the president on the ground with a little soot on his shoes, rather than looking out the window of Air Force One. Mm-hmm. He's not the only president to be criticized for showing up to a disaster and just looking out the window. But I do think that the people of New Mexico would have appreciated all of this gesture. And I think that it would have been subject to a little less criticism that it was intended as a campaign support for Michelle Lujan Grisham if they had been more open to the media and to the people of the state.
Good point, sir. I'd forgotten about the media access. That's a very good point, especially for the papers that are right on the doorstep of this or in the middle of it. There's something kind of bizarre about that, actually. Rebecca, I'm interested in your take on this as well. This, you know, could the president have just reached out just a little bit more, just a little bit closer? I understand he met with families behind the scenes, but what does that really do for anybody behind the scenes?
I think, you know, to echo the earlier point, you know, like it's not, like you need to be able to smell it. You need to be able to like feel it and touch it and actually meet with those residents on that land that has been passed down generation to generation that is now decimated. Mm-hmm. Because I can see something and say, wow, that is like, that's really important. I'm going to fight for it. But if I feel it, touch it, taste it, if he's going to fight that much harder to get those families what they deserve. It's never going to be enough. No amount of money, even if they can get full congressional support to give 100% back to those families who are already facing such struggles, like it's still never going to be enough because you can't bring those homes back. You can't bring those memories back. And I just think like it would have gone even that much farther if he would have just made a pit stop that somewhere a little closer to the action.
Rebecca, let me stay with you on this one. I understand what the president's looking to do here and what he's looking to pay for, so to speak. But was he clear enough on this 100% thing? Because it sounds like he's going to pay for all the machinations that go into fighting fires. And I'm not sure I really heard about making people whole at 100%. How did you hear that?
So my understanding is that the executive order that he signed does give full authority 100% to reimburse the government costs, the cost of the firefighters, the cost of the traffic control to evacuate folks, like those government costs. But I don't think, like, FEMA can't do more for individuals without congressional action.
Right.
So I think he did do the most that he is capable of doing, but does that really matter to New Mexicans? I think the people who really need the help, they're going to need more.
Yeah. You know, Tommy edged up on the edge of it, you know, talking about the history of some of the families and all that kind of a thing, but perhaps there was another step there. But let me ask you this as well. We're all looking for ways to wrap our arms around the problem that has so many variables, from climate change, issues with forest management, certainly. Did the president offer enough in terms of potential solutions to this issue?
No is the short answer. I didn't hear solutions. I did hear that the what the president said as far as, you know, making the state whole and state and government whole. I believe that there is proposed legislation that would provide the same benefits to the individuals and communities that were impacted, that were similar to the Cerro Grande fire that impacted Los Alamos and other communities. But outside of that, you know, they're really, and I don't think this necessarily was a time to get into policy discussions about, you know, the value or, you know, what happened and stuff with regards to the prescribed burns and the pile burn. I think this is more of a therapeutic visit as opposed to, you know, let's roll up our sleeves and, you know, get it done. And by the way, this is the first that I've actually heard about, you know, the restricted press access. And that's quite disappointing because, huge missed opportunity by the Biden administration not to allow, you know, the Las Vegas Optic and, you know, the other media in the area a chance to, including the Santa Fe Reporter, an opportunity to be in the room. Because, you know, that speaks volumes when a reporter or a photographer is actually in the room with the president. That's communicated. And I'm disappointed and sorry to hear that didn't happen.
Right. You know, the video of it just didn't quite, for me personally, didn't quite come off. The shot was too pulled back. A lot of it just didn't work in so many ways. Julie, I'm going to kind of circle back to something. And this is about FEMA and funding available for people whose homes have been lost or damaged. And you can apply on the FEMA website. But what I want to get at is the proposed legislation from Representative Teresa Ledger Fernandez that would offer full compensation for nearly all lost property and income linked to the wildfire. This, of course, as you mentioned earlier, is going to take some congressional help. In your mind, what would that look like to satisfy folks in northern New Mexico?
I mean, I have to agree that the legislation is going to come short. Even if what they're talking about now actually gets passed by Congress. I was reading a story that Yasmin Khan put together for KUNM about folks who are part of the land grant communities, right? So this is land that was given to people during the Spanish governance era in New Mexico, which some of our viewers from afar might not even know what we're talking about. But these are places where people have access to natural resources. They may have a residence or a family home that's not their primary residence. And so FEMA is bound by the federal law to only be able to compensate. You know, that it has a lot of regulations, but that's one of them, that, you know, you're only going to get the highest level of compensation for something that's, you know, identified as your primary residence. And so these are multi-generational properties in some cases, and sort of making that stipulation, it's going to mean that a lot of people are not sort of made whole in the parlance that we're talking about. Mm-hmm. I think it's also really important to point out what the federal government is going to have to do right away. And the Army Corps of Engineers just yesterday announced this contract with an Idaho Falls construction company, which is going to try to build some structures to protect the Las Vegas, the Guaynas watershed from the flooding, which will come with monsoon season. Mm. Some of us have, you know, I personally got to see the Santa Clara flooding, the aftermath of the fire that really affected the Santa Clara forest lands. And I think that you're going to, it's very likely, the experts are saying we're going to see similar or more detrimental flooding. And so protecting the watersheds now and using those federal contractors on a fast track to get that work done ahead of the rainy season is really important. And I was happy to see that that is happening.
I'm glad you brought that up, because that's the next step, obviously, in all of this and the flooding danger. Santa Clara went through their flooding, of course, back in, you know, a decade ago after the Cerro Grande fire. So they're no stranger to that either. Thanks to the panel for their reaction to the president's visit. We'll be back here for another discussion in just about 15 minutes when we take a closer look at some of the local races in last week's primary and the new lawsuit from the Secretary of State against Otero County officials.